Hello and welcome to this session on Jenkins on Docker. In this session, we are going to go very basic step by step and we will see how can we create a Jenkins server on a Docker container. And we will see how to start Jenkins on Docker container. We will see how can we start and stop the Jenkins container. We will also see how can we set Jenkins home or the home directory of Jenkins on Docker volume or the host machine's physical location. So this is going to be easy and interesting. So let's get started and let me open my terminal. Now, in case you are following this session on Windows, you can open your Windows command prompt or your PowerShell. And in case you are watching this on Linux, you can go to your Linux command line. I am recording this on a Mac operating system. So I'm going on terminal and I will also split my screen so that you can see the notes as well as the terminal window. Okay, so the very first step is we have to get the Jenkins image from Docker. So I'm going to my browser and I will go to Docker Hub. And here I will go to explore repositories. And here I will search for Jenkins. So you can see I have got this very first option, Jenkins. I will go to the details. And here you can see the Docker pull command is Docker pull Jenkins. And this command will pull the Jenkins image onto our local system. So I will say Docker pull Jenkins. So this is using the default latest tag and it will start pulling the Jenkins image. So now it is pulling all the required libraries from Docker Hub. So you can see this is the very first command, this one that we are running now. So now Docker pull is completed. Let me clear the terminal. And if I go to Docker images, you can see we have our Jenkins image created and this is the image ID. Okay, so we can also run Docker images and minus Q flag to just get the image ID and all these commands we have learned in the earlier session. So now we have just got the image. We do not have the container as of now. Even if we say Docker PS or Docker PS minus A to list all the containers, you can see there are no containers running as of now. So to create the container and to run the container, let us go back to our Docker Hub. And here, if you go a little down, you will find this command. This is for running the Docker container. So let us also understand this command. Here we are saying Docker run and -p command is to expose the port 8080 on the host system, which corresponds to 8080 port for the Docker server. And similarly, we are exporting port 50,000, which is for Jenkins API and the image name is Jenkins. Now, if you run this command, I can just copy and run this command here. This will start our Jenkins container, start our Jenkins server on a Docker container, and you will be able to access Jenkins by localhost 8080 on your system. However, with this command, the data or the Jenkins home directory where all our plugins, all our jobs, and all the information that we do on Jenkins is stored will be coupled with the container, and once you stop the container or delete the container, all the data will also be deleted with the container, and we do not want that. We want that we have a persistent storage for our Jenkins home directory. So for that, what you can do is, here is another command which says you can actually use the minus V flag here and then give a local location for your home, Jenkins home, which will correspond to where Jenkins home. Okay, so let us try this one out. And what I will do is I'll just copy this command and I will paste it here on my terminal. And here what I'm going to do is we are saying Docker run, and let me also give a name to this container. And we can say minus minus name, and I will say this is my Jenkins one. So I'm giving a name, which is optional step. And then we are saying minus P to expose port 8080 of the container to port 8080 of the host machine, and port 50,000 of the container or the server to port 50,000 on our host machine, and then minus V. And here I can give some physical location on my system. So I can say here I want to use users Raghav desktop, and I want to create a folder called Jenkins home here, which will correspond to the Jenkins server where Jenkins home directory, and this is the image. Okay, so I will start this now, and let me also show you how it will create a folder. So it should create a folder here on my desktop. So I am starting this, and you can see a Jenkins home folder is now created, and it is actually writing down all the Jenkins home elements or the data inside this folder. And you can see all this data is coming here. So this is going to be very useful when you work on actual enterprise level projects with Docker and Jenkins. So always do this step, and you can also actually create volumes, which I will show you in the next step. So let this process complete, and we have got this admin password that I will copy for reference. Now you can see the Jenkins is fully up and running. So we can go to our browser and go to localhost 8080. And you can see the Jenkins starting page. Here I will give the initial admin password. So this initial admin password you can get from the logs here. This is the password, or in case you do not find it here, you will always find it in the Jenkins home. There will be a secrets folder, and then here will be initial admin password. So you can find it here as well. And you have to give this here and continue. And now, because we are starting our Jenkins for the first time here, it is asking us to install some suggested plugins or to select plugins to install. You can click on install suggested plugins, but for now, to make the process faster, I will click on select plugins, and I'm actually going to click on none so that this process does not take a lot of time. And I will just go to install, and it is asking me to create an admin user. I will just continue as admin. You can create some user if you want. I will continue as admin and start using Jenkins. Now here we have got to our Jenkins dashboard. The very first thing I will do is I will go to my user here at the top right, and I will go to configure so that I can set some password here. I will just set some password that I can remember easily here, and apply and save. And now I will go to my Jenkins and go to here new item and create a job. So let me say this is job test one, a freestyle job, and say okay. And you see I am not getting a lot of options here because I have skipped all the plugins. So in your case you might get some more options, but that is fine for now. I'm just creating a shell command in the build step and apply and save. So the reason I am creating a job here is I just want to show what is the advantage of mounting or having a physical location of the Jenkins home directory. So you see I have created a test job here by the name job underscore test one. And now what I'm going to do is on my terminal, let me again split my screen. So you can see the Jenkins server is running. So I will open a new tab of the terminal, or you can open a new command prompt. And here I just want to check the running container. So I will say docker ps, and you can see our Jenkins is running, and my Jenkins is the name that we have given to this container, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop this container. So I will say docker stop. Now I can give the container ID here, which is this one, or I can also give the name that I gave to my container. So this is, I'm saying docker stop my Jenkins. And now if I go to the terminal which was running, you can see this is shutting down Winstone. So now it has come out of Jenkins server, and if I see there is no container running, but if I go to docker ps minus a, I can still see my container is there, but it is not running. So to start the container, I can say docker start and the container id or the container name. But what I'm going to do is I am going to remove this container. Okay, so if I go to docker ps minus a, there is no container. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a container again. So what I will do is I will create a container again, and this time I'm going to give it a different name. So I will say this is my Jenkins 2, and the port I can keep it as it is, or I can change the port number as well. So I want to start this on 9090, and this is okay. And now you see what I'm doing is I am setting up the same Jenkins home directory that I used for the earlier container and mapping it to the Jenkins home of the server for Jenkins. And I will run this. So the basic thing that I'm trying to show you here is by using a physical location, you can actually share your Jenkins jobs and plugins and all the data between containers. So I have already stopped and removed the earlier container, and this is a new Jenkins container I am starting. And let this server get started successfully, and then I will show you the Jenkins dashboard. So you can see Jenkins is fully up and running. And now if I go to localhost, 80 days anyways will be down, but now we can go to localhost 9090. So I will go to localhost 9090, and you can see our Jenkins is up, and it did not actually go to the very first page that comes normally with a new installation of Jenkins. It directly took us to the login page, and I'm actually using the credentials that I created on my earlier instance of Jenkins, and I will try to log in, and let us see if it allows us to log in. And you can see we have logged in successfully, and also you can see this is the job that we created earlier, which is available here as well. And the reason this is because we actually created a Jenkins home directory, and we are using the same Jenkins home for this container as well. Now I could have also started this new Jenkins container while the earlier one was already running, so even that I could have done. But I wanted to show you that even if you exit and remove the container, you still have the data, and you can persist the data by using this physical location. So this will be very handy when you want to use multiple containers, or you want to share your data between multiple containers, and you should always do this when you are working with enterprise projects. Now the other thing I wanted to show you is how you can set volumes. So what you can do is, instead of setting up this physical location, you can also say, if I go to docker volume and I go to docker volume create my Jenkins, and I say docker volume ls, so you can say my Jenkins volume is created. And do not worry, I am going to explain in detail about volumes in the next session, but for now just see what I am doing. I have just created a volume in docker, and now what I'm going to do is I will use the same command to start a Jenkins container. So I'll copy this command here, and I'm going to use the same command. However, instead of giving a physical location, I'm going to give the name of the volume that I just created. So I will say minus V flag, and the name of my volume was my Jenkins. And of course you can go and see the volume. For example, you can say docker volume ls to list the volume, and then you can say docker volume inspect and the volume name. So it gives us the details about the volume and the mount point. Mount point is where it is available. So the difference here is this volume, although it's available on the host machine, but you won't be able to see it, or the functions will not be able to touch or change this volume. So that is one of the advantage, and it becomes very easy to share between containers. So here I'm using this my volume, and I will do the same thing. I will just start my Jenkins container. Okay, so this is already in use. So let me use a different name for the container. I will say this is my Jenkins 3. So now this will start the Jenkins in the same way. However, instead of using a physical location, it is using a Docker volume. And this becomes very easy when we want to share the volumes between multiple containers and also want to persist our data. So while this is getting started, let me just say Docker inspect and the name of the container, which is my Jenkins 3. And here, if you go a little up, this is a JSON file. If you go a little up, you will have the section for mounts. And here you can see the volume, the type is volume, name is my Jenkins, and this is the source where it is located. Okay, so you can also use volumes for creating your data for your Jenkins server. We will learn more about volumes in the coming session. And this is how you start a Jenkins server on Docker container. And this is all about that you should be knowing while running Jenkins on Docker. I hope this session was very useful for you. I will meet you in the next episode. Thank you for watching.